Hi guys, welcome to InfoMix again.
In the previous videos, we discussed about logical equivalence. In this video, we'll discuss about logical implications, which are used in so-called rules of inference. Enjoy!
Please subscribe, click the bell, like, share, and put your comments below.
Let S and T be propositions. Whenever the evaluation of the implication, if S, then T, or also read as S implies T, gives all values 1s, then it is a tautology, and we write using this symbol.
We say that it is logical implication. Evaluation of propositions can be done using truth tables. Please check the video for truth tables here, or in the description below. Example, use a truth table to prove that open bracket, if P then Q, close bracket, and not Q, close bracket implies not P. Here, there are two variables, so there are 2 to the power 2, that is, 4 combinations of values of P and Q. We put P and Q schematically in the first and second columns like this. Then, in the third column, we evaluate P implies Q. This gives only 0 when P is 1 and Q is 0, otherwise 1s. In the fourth column, we put not Q. This is just the opposite of Q. In the fifth column, we evaluate open bracket P implies Q, close bracket, and not Q. This is the end of the third and fourth columns. In the sixth column, we put not P. This is just the opposite of P of the first column. Then, in the last column, we put the main implication. This is the fifth column implies the sixth column. We look for the rows where the fifth column is 1 and the sixth column is 0. We're going to put zeros in the last column for such rows, but there is no such a row. All values are 1s. So this implication is a tautology. It is a logical implication and we use this symbol for this. Some of the logical implications are considered to be very important, and they are applied to the so-called the rules of inference. In general, if we have this form of implication, P1 and P2 and P3 and so on, and Pn implies Q, then each of P1, P2, P3, and so on, and Pn is called premise, and Q is called conclusion. Here, if we have two premises, namely P implies Q and not Q, and the conclusion is not P, this is called the rule of modus tollens. This rule says that whenever P implies Q is true and not Q is true, then the conclusion not P is also true. We use these three dots indicating therefore or thus. Here are some of the rules of inference. We will mention how you can understand or memorize them. 1. Modus ponens. P implies Q and P therefore Q. Consider the following. Let P be it is raining and Q be John stays home. If P then Q will then be if it is raining, then John stays home. The fact is that it is raining. That is P. So, what do we conclude? Yes, John stays home. That is Q. 2. Modus tollens. P implies Q and not Q, therefore not P. Recall the contrapositive law. Click here for the laws of logic. The link is also put in the description below. P implies Q is logically equivalent to not Q implies not P. Use this law and the rule of modus ponens to get this modus tollens. 3. Syllogism. P implies Q and Q implies R, therefore P implies R.
You can associate this with the following: x smaller than y, and y is smaller than z. Therefore, x is smaller than z. This rule is also known as transitive rule. 4. Conjunction. P and Q, therefore P and Q. Recall the truth table of N. P and Q is only true if P is true and Q is true. If P is true and Q is true, then P and Q is also true. This rule is also called introduction of N. 5. Disjunctive syllogism. P or Q and not P, therefore Q. Recall the law of implor. P implies Q is logically equivalent to not P or Q. Then apply modus ponens to get through this rule. 6. Contradiction. Not P implies false, therefore P. Recall again the implor law. Not P implies false is equivalent to not P or false. Then apply the double negation to conclude P. 7. Conjunctive simplification. P and Q, therefore P, of course, by commutative law, P and Q, therefore Q. This rule is also known as elimination of N. If P and Q are both true, then one of them is true. 8. Disjunctive amplification. P, therefore P or Q, of course, by commutative law, Q, therefore P or Q, if one of them is true, then either one of them is true. Consider this. John is usually in the library at 1 p.m. So, if you want to find John at 1 p.m., he's in the library or in the class. That makes sense, right? This rule is also known as introduction of R. 9. Proof by cases. P implies R and Q implies R, therefore, open bracket, P or Q, close bracket, implies R. Note that in the both premises, P and Q implies both R. Now, to prove that S logically implies T, we can start with S and try to get to T, where in every step, we can use logical equivalence, that is the laws of logic, discussed in the previous videos. Or logical implication in this direction, that is the rules of inference. The links of the previous videos about laws of logic can be found in the description below. We can also start from T and go up to S, or we can start from S and T and meet somewhere in between. Usually, we start from the more complicated proposition. Now, let's see some examples. Example 1. Let the following propositions are defined as follows. P is, it rains. Q is, John goes to campus. R is, John stays at home. S is, John goes to the library. Prove the following proposition. If it does not rain, then John goes to campus. And if it rains, then John stays at home. And if John goes to campus, then John goes to the library. Implies if John does not stay at home, then John goes to the library. Proof, we use our symbolization defined above. So then we have to prove that if not P, then Q. And if P, then R. And if Q, then S. Implies if not R, then S. We start with the premises. If not P, then Q. And if P, then R, and if Q, then S. And try to reach to, if not R, then S. For each step, we may only use the logical equivalent, or we may use the logical implication in that direction, and not in the other direction, that is by using a rule of inference. Let's analyze this problem. Look at the conclusion. This is where we are going to. Here, S is on the right side of the implication. Now we have that in the premise, so that is okay. But on the left side of the implication, we have not R. In the premises, we do not have it. The only premise containing R is this premise.
where R is on the right side of the implication. So how to get its negation on the left side of the implication? Yes, we apply the contrapositive. So we put the equivalent sign, then this becomes, if not P, then Q, and if not R, then not P, and if Q, then S. So the reason is contrapositive. Now, let's apply commutative laws for this part. So this is equivalent to, if not R, then not P, and if not P, then Q, and if Q, then S. Now, we look at the rule of syllogism and apply it to these two implications. So, this logically implies. So, we put this symbol. If not R, then Q, and if Q, then S. Now, we apply the rule of syllogism again and get to the conclusion. If not R, then S. Now, we are done. The disadvantages of this way of proving are, it takes wider space because we have to write all the premises. Also, while working on only one premise, we have to write the other premises over the next step. Alternatively, here is how you can prove this. Let's number the premises like this. A. If not P, then Q. B. If P, then R. C. If Q, then S. And we are trying to get to the conclusion, if not R, then S. 1. If P, then R. This is premise B. 2. If not R, then not P. The reason is contrapositive of 1. 3. If not P, then Q. This is premise A. 4. If not R, then Q. By applying syllogism to 2 and 3. To make it easy to see, notice the order. 2 first, and then 3. 5. If Q, then S. This is a premise C. Therefore, we conclude that 6. If not R, then S. By applying syllogism to 4 and 5. So, we are done. Example 2. Let the following proposition are defined as follows. P is, it is Monday. Q is, John goes to campus. R is, it rains. Prove the following. If it is Monday, then John goes to campus. And if it rains, then John does not go to campus. And it rains implies it is not Monday. Proof. We use our symbolization defined above and number the premises. So then we have to prove that A if P, then Q. B if R, then not Q. C, R implies not P. We analyze the problem first. Look at the conclusion. It is not P. The only premise where P occurs is in premise A. But we need not P. How to get proposition contain not P from premise A? Implore is a possibility. Then premise A will become not P or Q. But how to get rid of the disjunction? Not easy. The other possibility is by a contrapositive of premise A. We try that one. 1. If P, then Q. This is premise A. 2. If not Q, then not P, by contrapositive of 1. 3. If R, then not Q, this is premise B. 4. If R, then not P, by applying syllogism to 3 and 2. To make it easier to see, notice again the order, 3 first, and then 2. 5. R, this is premise C. Therefore, we have the conclusion. 6. Not P by applying modus ponens to 4 and 5. So, we are done. Example 3. Prove that the following premises. A. If P, then Q. B. Not Q. C. Not R. Lead to the conclusion. Not open bracket P or R close bracket. We analyze the problem. Look at the conclusion. Not is outside the bracket. There are two ways we can approach this.
The first one is to get P or R first and then try to get the contradiction. The second possibility is using De Morgan. Considering the premises, it most likely the second case will be reasonable. So, this is equivalent to not P and not R. So, this will be our intermediate conclusion. Now, since it is N, so we need to have both not P and not R. Now, not R is already in a premise C. So, we only need to get to not P. How to get it? P appears only in premise A. Yes, we apply contrapositive to premise A. So, here we go. 1, if P, then Q. This is premise A. 2, if not Q, then not P, by applying contrapositive to 1. 3, not Q. This is premise B. 4, not P, by applying modus ponens to 2 and 3. 5, not R. This is premise C. 6, not P and not R, by applying rule of conjunction 2, 4, and 5. So, we get to the conclusion. We are done. Example 4. Prove that the following premises. A, if P, then open bracket, not Q or R, close bracket. B, Q or not P. C, P. Lead to the conclusion R. Proof. We analyze the problem. Look at the conclusion. It is R. We see that R only appears in premise A. In premise A, it appears in form of R with not Q. But it is not easy to eliminate R. So we have to convert it to an implication form first. That is using Implore law. The same way for premise B. We need to convert it to implication form using implore. So, here we go. 1. If P then, open bracket, not Q or R, close bracket, this is premise A. 2. If P then, open bracket, if Q, then R, close bracket, by implying implore law to 1. 3. P, this is premise C. 4. If Q, then R, by applying modus ponens to 2 and 3. 5. Q or not P. This is premise B. 6. Not P or Q. Commutative of 5. 7. If P, then Q. By applying implore to 6. 8. Q. By applying modus ponens to 7 and 3. Therefore, we get the conclusion. 9. R. By applying modus ponens to 4 and 8. Now, we are done. That's all for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Hopefully, you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye!